Hi friends, I am Ankit Jaiswal. I am the co-founder of Ihaveakt, and I have done my BE from Datta Mehgi College of Engineering, Airoli. And today we are going to discuss about how we can clear BEE, or I can say how we can get 32 in BEE. Okay, so if we see the blueprint of BEE, all the questions which are asked, the paper pattern, this is the paper pattern. Okay, so this is my planning for BEE. And here are the set of topics which we should do to get to clear BEE easily. Okay, so the topics which we are covering are DC, three phase, electronics and transformers. We are not covering AC in this because many students find AC difficult, but then for students who are from electronics, electrical and EXCC, it is better that you know the basics of AC because you might require it in the years coming, like in the second year, third year. Okay, for other branch students, if you do a DC three phase electronics and transformers properly, you can clear BEE very easily. So coming to DC, in DC we have got 9 topics: basic Kirchhoff's laws, mesh analysis, nodal analysis, source transformation, star delta, superposition theorem, Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem, maximum power theorem. Now, first three topics, basic Kirchhoff's laws, mesh analysis and nodal analysis. This topic is very important from DC point of view because these three laws will be used in all the topics, all the following topics, L9, maximum power theorem. Okay, this topic comes for 6 marks in question number 2, but as I have planned, we are not attempting question number 2. But then still you should do this topic because we are going to use this. We are going to, basics are to be used in this. Okay. Now source transformation and star delta. Source transformation and star delta comes for overall 10 marks. One question comes in question number 1A and the other question which comes in question number 4A, 7 marks. So overall 10 marks is for source transformation. So this topic you should do nicely. Question number in question number 1, basic basic circuit will be given and wherein you will have to like find the equivalent resistance. So in that store, star delta might be used, or you will be told to find the equivalent circuit using source transformation. Okay. Next we have got superposition theorem. We have got a question on superposition theorem in question number 6A, which is for 7 marks. Okay. And then the following topics: Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem, and maximum power theorem. This overall comes for 11 marks. One in question number 1B here, and then the second is in question number 5A. Question number 5A, Thevenin's, Norton's and maximum power theorem. Okay, so overall this topic comes for 11 marks. These topics are similar. The basics of this are used here. Okay. In question number 1, B here, a theorem will be asked. Maybe you will be told to state and explain the Thevenin's theorem, Norton's theorem or maximum power theorem. Or a basic sum will be given and you will be told to find equivalent Thevenin circuit or equivalent Norton circuit. Okay. So this is our DC. This is about DC. So if we do DC and the questions which we have planned, what I have planned is what you should attempt is question number 1, question number 3, question number 4, and then question number 5 or question number 6, depending on which is easier. So if we are attempting question number 1, so it is 6 marks for DC. Question number 4, we have got 7. Question number 5 or 6, that is for 8 marks or 6 marks. So overall, DC will fetch you with 6 plus 7, 13. 13 plus 8, 21. Okay, so overall 21 marks is for DC. So we have got 21 marks for DC. Now coming to three phase. In three phase, there is a question in question number 1E, which is a straightforward question wherein you will be asked for draw only phasor diagram of star delta, or you will be asked a basic voltage and current equation for star and delta. This is for 2 marks, a straightforward question. Okay, so you can refer the textbook, and only phasor diagram. They will tell you to draw only the phasor diagram of star or delta connection. Then we have got a sum on different power calculation for star and delta. Here in this question, you will have to understand if the question is for star or if the question is for delta, and use the formulas accordingly. So this is a straightforward question for 8 marks. It is based on only formulas, okay, which comes in question number 3A. We have got two questions on two wattmeter. There is a sum and there is a theory. In theory, we have got measurement of three phase power for star or delta. This is almost a fixed question asked in every paper. Okay, so but then it might be asked for star or it might be asked for delta. In the books, we have been given only one. So you will have to derive the second one accordingly. Other questions which might come instead of this are advantages of the above method. They might tell you to like explain star or delta, measurement of three phase power for star or delta, and then also mention the advantages. Okay, this can be one question, or equation of power factor cos phi. Okay, this is important, and the sum of two wattmeter comes on the power factor. So this topic is comparatively very important. It comes for 10 marks. So if you do 2 wattmeter, it will fetch you 10 marks. The questions are in question number 4C. We have got question number 4C, 3 phase. Here comes it for 2 wattmeter. And then in question number 4, question number 4C and question number 6C. Question number 6C, this is the 2 wattmeter question. This comes for 6 marks. So overall 10 marks, this topic will give you 10 marks. And then we have got some in question number 3A, 8 marks. And then one question for 2 marks in question number 1. So overall this 3 phase will fetch you 20 marks. So overall if you do DC and 3 phase properly, you can easily attempt a paper of 41 marks. Okay, so we are planning of 32, but then I will be suggesting you to go for other topics also, because they are easy, and in case a paper comes tough, you can always attempt these questions and clear it easily. So coming to electronics, it is a fixed question. We have got 4-5 fixed questions. Wherein one question is on half phase, full phase, center tap, or bridge rectifier. Okay, wherein you will be told to draw a diagram, waveforms, and explain them. Okay. In next, we have got we have got a question on filter. So what is filter, types of filter, then L, C, AC, or pi filter. You will be told to write a short note on this for 2 marks. So basically, you should know the waveform, the circuit, and then a short explanation on that. And then we have got a question on BJT. This is a question on BJT, wherein a C configuration BJT is normally asked, wherein you will told to draw a diagram working in one question. Okay, you will they will be telling you to draw the diagram and waveform for C configuration, or they will be telling you to draw input output characteristics of BJT and explain them. So this can be a question. This is a fixed question. A topic on this question is fixed. A topic on this question is fixed. This is for 4 marks. This is for 4 marks. And we have got a 2 mark question from this. Okay. And a 2 mark question again on any of these topics. So overall, this topic will fetch you 12 marks. These topics are comparatively easy. This you can do in 2 hours. Okay. So this is very easy, which will help you to fetch 12 marks. Now let's see where are these 12 marks. We have got one question for 2 marks in question number 1A. We have got a question in question number 3A. Question number 3, C and D. That's for total 6 marks. And then we have got a question in question number 4, D, electronics, for 4 marks. So overall, this topic will fetch you around 12 marks. Now coming to transformers. Transformers, the chapter is quite big. And then if you do a selected questions, you can it's easy. There is a fixed question in 90% of papers, a fixed question on EMF equations of transformer, wherein you will be told to write EMF, to prove EMF equation of transformer, or a basic sum will be asked on that. Or you can be told to explain various losses in transformers, or derive condition for maximum efficiency of transformer. This is again an important question. This can be asked for 8 marks also. Okay. So basically for question number 1, 4 mark transformer question, any of this can come. This can also come for 8 marks. And then we have got a question on SCOC test, and we have SCOC test wherein theory can be a theory and sums are asked in many of the papers. So we have got SCOC test theory and SCOC test sum in paper. In almost 90% papers we get these two questions together. If it is not, then we have got this question wherein derive condition for maximum efficiency of transformer for 8 marks. Okay, so transformers, we have got a question in question number 1F, 4 marks. Here in question number 2, mostly they will ask phaser diagram. This is comparatively tough, so I mostly leave this section. Okay. Here we have got an SCOC question on transformer, and then we have got a transformer question in question number 5. Okay, so question number 5C, transformer SCOC. Now here in question, depending on which question is easier, you can attempt either question number 5 or either question number 6, because we have got a question on 3 phase wattmeter and DC superposition. Here we have got DC Thevenin's, Norton's and maximum power, and so and transformer SCOC test. So the one which you know the better, you should go for that. This is a straightforward theory and a sum, mostly I go for this. But sometimes if we get a good question here, a good sum, easy sum, we might go for this. SCOC test sums are easier, you need to practice and go. Okay, so if we see the planning, what we are doing, we will be what you should attempt is question number 1, we have got 2 on DC, and then 3 phase 1 transformer and electronics. These are easier, which will fetch you about 40 marks. Then we have got question number 2, which we are skipping, like this we are not attempting. In question number 3, we have got a question on 3 phase, some 8 marks, transformer SCOC test 6 marks, electronics and electronics. This question is comparatively easy, which will fetch you around 20 marks. Here mostly the theory of SCOC test is asked. Then in question number 4, we have got DC, AC, 3 phase and electronics, wherein we are skipping again electronics. So DC, source transformation, 3 phase, 2 watt meter, and then in question number 4D, electronics, okay, for 15 marks. Then in question number 5, we have got DC, Thevenin's, Norton's and maximum power theorem, AC, transformers, SCOC test and DC superposition theorem. So in question number 4, it will be DC, source transformation, AC as we are skipping, so we will not be attempting AC question. But then in question number 4C, we have got a 3 phase and then a question on electronics. So overall this question will fetch you 7 plus 4 plus 4, this is 8 plus 7. So around 15 marks you can attempt from this question. Now coming back to question number 5 and 6, here the best which you know should you should attempt. We have got a question on Thevenin's and Norton's and a transformer SCOC. Mostly we get a sum here, or we get a question on derived condition for maximum efficiency of transformer. So a question, that question come, or there can be any other, we can get a sum for 8 marks, a basic sums on transformers for 8 marks in this section. Okay, so depending on which is easier. In question number 6, we have got DC superposition and then a 3 phase wattmeter. So if question number 5 comes easier, you should go for this, or either you should go for question number 6, because we have got a 3 phase 2 wattmeter theory question 6 and then a DC superposition theorem question 6. So overall if you see this 14, this 20, this 15, and then a 13 or 16 in this. So well, you can attempt easily about a paper of around 60 marks here. Okay, so if you cover all these topics, it will help you to attempt a paper of 60 marks wherein you can easily get 32. Okay, I hope this helps you in understanding how you can plan your studies for BEE. And I hope you clear BEE easily. Thank you.